Francis Fowle, and I'm senior curator at the Scottish National Gallery in Edinburgh and a reader in history of art at Edinburgh College of Art, University of Edinburgh. Today I'm going to talk about Childe Hassam's Commonwealth Avenue, which was painted 1892. It's an interesting painting. We had this picture at the exhibition of American Impressionism in Edinburgh in 2014. I was really struck by it at the time, and by the fact that Hassam's so varied in the way that he works, in his technique and in his subjects as well. Although he was known as the painter of the street, so it seemed appropriate to choose something which reflects that. His technique is quite sort of, it's not like the French Impressionist technique. It's drawing on different traditions, and he always maintained, I think he liked to play down the influence of Monet on his work. He always maintained that he learned how to paint in this way before he left Boston, so before he went to Paris in 1886. And the artist that he used to talk about most enthusiastically was the Dutch artist Jonkind, who taught him this manner, which is often referred to as peinture claire. So it's painting with a very kind of light palette, and painting on a sort of smaller scale, giving an impression that it's, one certainly gets the impression from this painting that's been worked or painted out of doors, which is probably not the case, in fact. The thing that strikes me technically is the difference between the way that the sky is painted and the rest of the painting. So the sky is, there's no kind of variation at all in texture or in colour, apparently. It's painted very smoothly. It's quite an academic style. Whereas if you look at the detail of the street and the trees and the pavement, you know, he's using these very kind of divided brushstroke, this fragmented brushstroke, which one associates with Impressionism. But actually, it's almost closer to pointillism or neo-impressionism in certain areas. He's really using these kind of small strokes of paint and exploring complementary colours. It's assumed that this picture was painted in autumn, but in fact, when you analyse it, the leaves on the trees are predominantly green. There are some elements of red, and this was used very often by the Impressionists to just give it a more intense effect. And actually, I think also to contrast with the red sidewalk, for example. What's striking is the brushstrokes themselves. So on the sidewalk, they're very horizontal, and on the street, they're kind of more diagonal. So they're following the actual line of the direction. You're kind of being drawn back into the painting. And there are other kind of devices that he uses, compositional devices, such as the gas lamps, these lampposts, the uprights of the trees, these elm trees that kind of draw you back into the distance and actually force you to look at the detail in the distance. When you look at it, you've got this very kind of plunging perspective, and this is something which he'd explored in earlier works. For example, when he was working in Boston before he went to France, he painted, he liked to explore different atmospheric effects, but was very influenced, I think, by the work of Gustave Caillebotte, whose work he saw in Boston before he went to France. And Caillebotte equally adopts these kind of rather dramatic perspectives, often high viewpoints or looking off into the distance. And so this painting was executed in Boston. Well, it shows Boston. It was probably based on sketches that were made when Hassam returned to the USA in the autumn of 1889. But by 1892, he was actually living in New York. So it's a nostalgic kind of look back at the city that he was actually raised in and that he worked in. And so it has close associations for him. But it was a city that was in transition. It's a city that was modernizing itself. And this broad boulevard, this Commonwealth Avenue, was the first of these grand boulevards to be laid out in the United States, in fact. It was built in an area which is known as the Back Bay, which was really land which was kind of recovered from marshland. And we're looking in the painting northeast towards Boston Common. And you can see, if you look very carefully into the painting, you can see a little white memorial on the Common, which was a memorial from the Civil War. The boulevard was laid out with these wonderful trees along the lines of the French redesign of Paris under Baron Haussmann. The designers were very much influenced by what was going on, the activities in Paris. So it is like a French boulevard. It's an open, very wide open street. It was 240 feet wide, and it was lined with these wonderful elm trees, so you had a shady spot to walk in. And it was very much the area you went to walk and to be seen. The other thing I'd like to kind of look at in the painting is the, if you see on the right-hand side, there are these two tall buildings, church edifices. One, the steeple, a Gothic spire. And then on the left, we have this much more kind of blocky Romanesque building, which was actually the church, the First Baptist Church. And quite an interesting building as you begin to look more closely at it. Apparently, Hassam painted this whole picture from sketches that he made earlier, and he may have actually painted some of it from memory, because some of the details are actually not accurate. For example, the window on the side of the building has been sort of made to look slightly more aesthetically pleasing. So among the sculptures on this Romanesque tower, there are the likenesses of Abraham Lincoln and also Charles Sumner, who were leading activists in the anti-slavery movement, both of them. And it's just interesting to consider whether Hassam was kind of consciously aware of that when he painted the picture, and because he makes it so prominent in the painting. And then again, I suppose one looks back to the memorial at the end of the avenue, and the juxtaposition of these kind of moments in the painting with these very genteel middle class people who are walking up and down is kind of, it just gives one pause for thought.